So when it comes to nutrition and diet information, the struggle is real in trying to figure out what's true or not. And it's important to keep in mind that we're getting our healthy eating recommendations. It's important to keep in mind where we're getting our healthy eating recommendations, especially when it's online. So as you can probably tell by these memes, there are a lot of bad or false information out there. So because everyone thinks that they're a nutrition expert nowadays. And so whether the topic is paleo, sugar, non-GMO, or local, everyone has an opinion. But remember that opinions are not facts. And so just because one diet plan or lifestyle change worked for one person doesn't mean that it'll work for another person. So nutrition is science solely based on recommendations from registered dietitians, and that's evidence-based. And so POGE can be hard, but there's no reason for nutrition to be. And so now let's review the top nutrition tips from a dietitian.
Okay, I'm not a dietitian. I'm sorry for running a little late. I am a dietetic intern. My name is Rebecca Hernandez. And so, as Grace said, she does interning with our dietitian, and I do as well as part of the coordinated program in dietetics here at UT. So here are some of the tips Grace has been talking about. And number one is that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. And between staying up late and pressing the snooze button in the mornings, most students don't make the time for breakfast. However, your parents were right, this is the most important meal. And just because it fuels you with the energy you need to take on your everyday activities, it has also been linked with numerous health benefits as well as weight control. So as important as eating in the morning is, you might as well also do more harm to your body if you do not get the right food into your system. Now, the best breakfasts are between 300 and 500 calories. They must be high in protein and also rich in carbohydrates. Now, protein offers that satiety aspect of it. It helps rebuild your muscles after your sleep, while carbohydrates are broken down for the energy. Now, don't be afraid to mix in healthy fats as well, just because those are also helping you with your satiety and are needed for many bodily functions. So, fun fact is that half of your brain is made up of fat, so that also goes in as well. Now, just remember to eat within 30 minutes to an hour from waking up. That will ensure that your blood sugar does not drop too low afterwards or cause any feelings of weakness or dizziness after you wake up.
So now, if you're the type of person who sets like three alarms in the morning or don't have time for breakfast, then here are some healthy combos that you can try. So scrambled eggs with low fat milk and an orange. And you can also microwave eggs, take scrambled eggs in less than 2 minutes. And or oatmeal with sliced apples, walnuts, and cinnamon, a granola bar and a banana, or a Greek yogurt and blueberries.
All right, so tip number two, smart snacking. Now, snacking tends to be frowned upon, especially in terms of ruining your appetite for dinner, but snacking can be very healthy as well, if done properly. Now, snacking can boost your energy between meals and supply essential vitamins and minerals, but keep these best practices in mind. Now, first of all, snack only when you're hungry. Don't snack in when you're feeling stressed out or just out of boredom. Snacks are not meals. They're meant to take you or to tie you over into that next meal. So try to keep your snacks between 150 to 200 calories. Now learn to plan in advance as well, so that healthy and ready-to-eat foods are really accessible for you whenever you feel that need to snack.
Healthy pantry staples. So you want to aim to keep healthy foods in your pantry with a longer shelf life. So some examples are nuts, peanut butter, oatmeal, granola bars, low sodium soups, and frozen fruit. In addition, you should always restock perishable items every week or every other week, including raw veggies, eggs, milk, yogurt, cheese, hummus, which are good refrigerator staples, in addition to whole grain bread, tortillas, tortilla chips, and fresh fruit.
All right, so tip number three, size matters. And while it's great to have all the healthy options and food in hand in terms of snacking, it's just as important to watch how So anything in excess is bad, including our healthy foods. So keep this phrase in mind. The size does matter, and what we mean about that is portion control. So anyone eating on the run, out of restaurants, or even in fast food places, you've noticed that portions have been gotten bigger over time. And some of them are even labeled as super size, if you've seen. And they may even provide enough calories to, you know, to sustain you for an entire day in just one meal. So how are some of the ways that you can tell that you have the proper size in your plate in terms of portions? Does anyone know? Yes? Yes, exactly. So there are ways. I mean, you could use your fist, you could use even visuals to kind of have an idea of your portion sizes. But if you're not sure, we can use some common references.
Discuss some common portion size references. It should be the proper amount of food that your body needs. Doesn't have to be hard. If you look at an average 2,000 calorie diet, you just need to consume 3 cups of dairy, 2 cups of fruits, 3 cups of veggies, 5 to 7 grams of protein, and 6 to 8 ounces of greens. And keep in mind that this is the average, and so everyone has individualized needs based on their age, height, weight, gender, and physical activity level. So if you would like to learn more about your individual needs, then you can visit www.choosemyplate.gov.
All right, so these lead to our tip number 4, which is everything in moderation, even moderation. And when talking about portion sizes, you can help lead into this topic, just because a healthy diet is not an all or nothing proposition. Starvation diets or diets that even offer a quick fix to nutrition can be harmful to your health. There is no one food that is going to, you know, break out being healthy, or there is no one food that, you know, backfires. You can't blame one food either for being unhealthy. So the only safe way to lose weight, to stay healthy, to feel good, is to actually have a balanced diet and meal, which focuses on moderation and activity. So you want to have lean proteins in every meal, fiber-rich carbohydrates, healthy fats, and all of these in moderation will ensure that you do get all the vitamins and minerals you need to keep up with your daily activities.
And so tip number 3, listen to your body. So regardless of the time of day, if you're hungry, then you're hungry. So denying yourself isn't going to change that, but rethinking how you're eating throughout the day might. And so mindful eating is about choosing foods that are both pleasing to you and nourishing to your body. It's about acknowledging your responses to food, such as likes, dislikes, feelings of hunger and satiety. So learn to eat until you're full so that you're not creating an opening for cravings later on in the day. Also remember that eating is not a race or competition, so take your time. It takes your body about 20 minutes to feel full, so chew properly, set your fork down between bites, and listen to your body so that you can stop eating when you're satisfied, not stuffed.
Tip number 6, don't fight stress and boredom with food, please. With mindful eating, you want to focus on eating when you're hungry, not when you're feeling these kinds of things. Now, I know some of us have even experienced the hangry emotion, or you frequently crave like sweets and salty snacks when you are feeling stressed out, and this is perfectly normal. And I know it can be tempting to reach out for those chips, those drinks, but try to take over that stress in a healthier way. You know, you're not going to fight that off with food, and it's not going to go away after you have that sweet. So you might as well try to find healthier ways. For example, go out for a walk, go out for a jog, meditate. Some of us have been doing yoga, dance, sing, take a nap. All of these things are healthy ways to de-stress. And just, even if you need this, try to get professional support. Utilize the resources we have here on campus. And one of them for sure is the Counseling and Mental Health Center, which is located in the Student Services Building over in Dean Keaton. So even reach out to your dietitian, who does have all these tips on hand in case you do need them.
Tip number 7, swimming out with exercise. In addition to helping reduce stress, Physical activity can also help control weight and improve your mood. So aim for about 130 minutes per week of moderate exercise to support a healthy lifestyle. 30 minutes a day, 5 times a week is an easy goal to remember. And so if you're looking for resources on campus, visit Rec Sports or Rec Gym. And so Rec Sports offers group exercise classes, clinics and series, personal training, and much more. And so you can take classes on everything from swimming to Pilates or tennis and cycling. And if that's not motivation enough for you to work out, then grab a buddy, grab your roommate, grab your friend. Working out with a friend provides extra motivation and forces you to be more accountable and following through versus working out solo and making excuses to not go when you don't feel like it.
All right, tip number 8, don't drink your calories. Of course, you know, as Grace said, you're working out, you're moving, you are sweating, so you need to do replenish all that sweat you lose. However, so for someone who is trying to watch their weight, who you want and who's also taking care of their diet, you do not want to drink those calories, you know, via liquids. Just because the weight sometimes creeps up on us that way, we sometimes don't realize it. So this is especially true when we have those sugary drinks. Let's say our sodas, our sweet teas, our fancy coffee drinks, those macchiatos.